Over the last four decades, we've lost 90% of the big animals from the ocean. In the last 10 years, we've lost one third of the coral reef from bleaching. We're in the midst of a global biodiversity extinction.
There is no permission for fishing here.
Fisheries across the world are either overfished or full capacity. We keep putting more boats in the water, but we cannot extract any more fish out of the sea. One in four fish is caught illegally. A lot of seaship work has been on the high seas, chased trawlers through long distances. This is very much front line. It's really making a difference. You have to be visible. You've got to be out there at the coalface actually working. Sea Shepherd is a non-governmental organisation dedicated to the conservation of marine wildlife. We're here on the Seahorse, Sea Shepherd's newest ship that we're using on operational campaign Milagro in the Sea of Cortez. This operation is primarily about trying to protect the world's rarest marine mammal, the vaquita porpoise.
Vaquitas are the smallest cetacean, it's a porpoise, that's endemic to the upper Gulf of California. You cannot find them anywhere else in the world. I always describe them to people as a small dolphin, but they don't have the characteristic beak of a dolphin, so their head is more round. They measure 1.5 meters, and they have black marks around their eyes and their mouth. They have the nickname Panda of the Sea.
The vaquita is sometimes accidentally caught, particularly in poachers' nets. The fish that the poachers are targeting is exactly the same size as a small vaquita, so the poachers often accidentally catch vaquita.
Poachers really target totoaba, but I've seen many other animals entangled in these totoaba nets. I've seen tons of quail, sharks, turtles, sea lions, dolphins, and whales entangled. They're really deadly, the big mesh size nets.
The totoaba is a big fish that is endemic to the Gulf. It was the first fish species to be on the IUCN threatened and endangered list. So it is illegal to catch totoaba.
Poachers will go for totoabas to sell their swim bladder in the black market. The totoaba swim bladder has a high value. The price per weight is higher than gold.
For a while, the campaign, it was crazy. There was a lot of poaching. We pulled up literally thousands of nets. The poachers, the nets are very expensive, so they didn't like people coming and pulling up their nets. We had a lot of conflict. We had people throwing petrol bombs at the ships. We had poachers trying to board the ships. There was a lot of gunfire.
Poachers keep throwing stones, but the harm is here.
Over time, since we've been here, that conflict is going down. Nowadays, we find the poachers very quickly. It's much more difficult for them to undertake their activities without being discovered. Ghost nets is a huge issue. We've literally pulled thousands of them out of here. The problem is they're made of plastic and the plastic stays forever and they just keep hatching fish forever unless you find them and pull them out.
The reason why the vaquita are still alive is because what we've done here. All the nets, all the totoaba legal fishing gear that we have retrieved is what has really made a change.
I'm absolutely convinced if we weren't here, there would be no vaquita left. All the vaquita would be dead. So the fact that there's still some rain in vaquita, I think is a result of this operation we've had here. The Sea Shepherd crews are just incredible. They're great global citizens. They have very strong ethical values around conservation. The crews of the ships are more and more Mexican crewed, and we're trying to get the Mexican run operation by Sea Shepherd Mexico. I've been so lucky that I've seen the most incredible wildlife. I want my grandchildren to be able to see vaquita, to be able to see coral reefs and the beauty of the marine ecosystems and marine wildlife.
Unfortunately, there's many species that are in the brink of extinction or they're really threatened. This is why I'm still fighting. I'm fighting for the future of the vaquita. This is work that we have to keep doing. It's what the world needs right now.
It's such an important campaign. The world is looking at this campaign because the vaquita, it's the most threatened marine mammal, and the totoaba is the most threatened marine fish. It's a challenging campaign, but a very important one.